So, here's a fun thing. I've made it to Madagascar. It's about, it's like 3:30 in the afternoon. I made it to the hotel, the little secluded resort thing that I'm gonna stay at for the night. But my bag didn't make it on the flight. So a lot of stuff I need. All the food. I have most of the food. My backpack I have, that was carry-on, but the check bag that had the remainder of the food, plus a lot of the gear, not here. Did not come off the carousel, not here. I'm hoping it's just misplaced, that I'll get a call here in a little while and they found the bag. Not real hopeful. So that means it will show up potentially on the next flight, which is this time tomorrow, but I will already be in the next city by then, with check-in. Anyway, I don't really expect to see my bag. Grand start to this trip. The flights were shitty. Just a lot of time just flying. My nerves and food and flights and time zone shifts. My stomach hasn't been feeling the greatest. I haven't been sick or anything, no diarrhea, none of that. It just doesn't feel real well. Didn't sleep much last night at all. Really not at all. Hoping to sleep tonight. Try to get into the rhythm of the time zone changes. Really, I'm just in a bum mood right now. I'm really in a bum mood. I'm apparently not the only one whose bag didn't show up on the carousel. Most people's did, but there were four or five people, plus myself, no bag. This is an incredibly poor country. Just the 8-minute ride from the airport to here. Saw a lot of people and a lot of rundown shacks. A lot of dirt roads, a lot of open sewer drainage. This wicked cool, like, I don't know, I would almost call it like a locust storm, but they weren't locusts, but just this mass migration of insects coming out of the trees. Huge, dark cloud of insects. Really wicked cool. So I'm here. I have a bed for the night in a pretty, I say it's a pretty nice place in the middle of what looks pretty awful. It's kind of this little like island of tranquility amongst all the chaos around. The flight is early tomorrow morning. I gotta be out of here, catch my ride to the airport at 4 in the morning. It's gonna be loads of fun. Things appear to run at a much different pace, kind of their own pace. I don't know. So we'll go to Diego Suarez. We'll fly up there, meet up with everybody else, let the organizers know that hey, I don't have a lot of my stuff. And we'll see what happens from there. If my bag doesn't show up, I'm hoping with the charity of others, a few bars here, a few items there, maybe a waiver or penalty or whatever from the organizers, but just I would still like to do this thing. I don't want to just be like, well, you can't run. That's going to be a shitty deal. I don't know that I really want to spend a week here not doing the race. But I wouldn't have a whole lot of choice. I doubt I could get my flights pushed, and it's just, it's weird. I don't like the feeling in the place that I'm in right now. I'm really down in the dumps. Kind of knew this was gonna happen, just the logistics of this thing. Second guessing even having signed up for this. But I'm here. In this tranquil place. Yeah. A shitty deal. Okay, so it's the same evening, a little later, now it's 7:40 in the evening. I jet, oh, an email. Oh, this might be even better news. Oh. Wi-Fi is a little slow. So anyway, I went to have dinner. The airline was not picking up for the baggage claim. Didn't really think it was going to get anywhere there. I'll try to check it in the morning. Still not expecting to find my bag. And go to have dinner. As I'm going to the desk to call the airline, there's a gentleman standing there. I just casually said hello. He, in a very surprised tone, turns and says hello to me. He was ecstatic that someone was speaking English. name is Greg. Very nice gentleman. We had a very pleasant chat. He's from Salem. And that was that. Then I go have dinner. Sit down, order, da da da. Greg and his wife, Patty, come in. Patty was excited to meet someone speaking English who happens to be from essentially neighbors, right? They're from Salem. I told them I was from Olympia. It's close enough. They asked me to come have dinner with them. Okay. So we just had dinner for an hour and a half. Talked about all manner of things. They were just ecstatic to just have somebody to converse with, and we shared all kinds of stories. They were here doing some charity work, doing tree plantings for 10 trees or 10 seedling, 10 trees. Anyway, they've all figured it out. So anyway, I tell them about my little incident with the lost luggage, and I'm trying to run this race, and I need, there's some items that I need, and blah blah blah. And as it would happen, they're leaving to go home tomorrow. To which they then say, "Would you like some of our stuff?" So they were so kind, so gentle. I have aspirin, Band-Aids, a small towel, a couple more protein bars, three more protein bars. This will help calorie count. Floss, hand sanitizer, big one. A whole lot of bug repellent, way more than I was bringing before, but I don't have any right now, so this is good. And moleskin. I lost the blister kit, so this should get me a long way through the blister kit nonsense. And an inflatable sleeping pad. Yes! I kept the sleeping bag, not the sleeping pad. I told them I'd mail this back to them when I got back. They gave me their address, down in Salem. So, this email is still not loading. I'm not sure what I can do about it. So I had food. I got some real food in me. Before I left for dinner, I found there actually was a heater in here because the whole thing is concrete and stone. It was getting a little chilly. Found a heater, came back toasty warm.
So that's good.
So yeah, I think tomorrow, if I can get, if Samantha's email would ever load, I think I'm just going to fly north and hope for the best. I'm sure I'll see a whole plethora of people tomorrow morning on the flight, so I can commiserate with them and see if anyone has really some extra food items, maybe a couple of batteries, and then just see what I can do once there. I mean, I can't imagine they won't let me run if I don't have a compass. There's no navigation involved. So we'll see. Maybe I'll just get docked points, whatever that means. Come on!
Load.
I'd like to know what Samantha has to say. So. What are we doing? So all in all, it was a good encounter. Very positive encounter. A good sign, I think.
Loading.
Anyway, that's enough for now. See you in the morning.